Hi everybody! Excuse me, I thought I would do a quick video of my main god and goddess altar and kind of show you what I've got on there and let you know what I do at the altar and that sort of thing. What I thought I would do is start at the bottom though. There's not much on here, top or bottom, so sorry about that. Okay. So, the first thing I have is this really cool plaque. It's clay. I got it at the thrift store. I was so excited when I found it. It's from the Metropolitan Museum of History, of Art, I'm sorry. I don't know which one because I found it at the thrift store, but it's really cool. And this is of Ba, and I might be pronouncing that wrong, I'm sorry. But Ba would assist souls in leaving their tombs and joining the Ka, or their Ka, and fly them to the next step in the afterlife and to the judgment hall of Ma'at. So I was really stoked to find this. It's like super cool. And I couldn't tell you what this kind of bird is. It looked like a turkey, but it's not a turkey. Anyways, so then I have these really cool wooden box things. They got like this gray felt in them. They have some kind of something. They're beautiful. And they're wood. They're really, really beautiful. And I just keep them down here because they just, I don't know, they seem in the perfect place. So I have some books down here, Isis Magic, and then I have more of a academic type of book, Ancient Egypt, and it's really cool. It's got beautiful pictures of the Nile and the culture around the Nile. It goes over, or it shows pictures of the obelisks, the Sphinx, the pyramids, tombs, hieroglyphics, temples. It's just gorgeous. A gorgeous book. Then I have Circle of Isis and Egyptian Symbols. This is a really cool book. And this book at the end is a journal for this Egyptian Symbols. And then I have a journal next to my Isis Magic book, which is my journal for walking through the House of Isis. It's actually just for the votary portion of it. So, and then I just have this little thing. It's really, there's really no purpose for it. I just basically have it for my matches. So that's at the bottom. And this is an old antique table. It's that I found in the basement when I moved here, so it was perfect. Okay, so up here, I have my goddess, which is Isis. Now, Isis was associated with life and the winds and abundance and definitely magic. And she was also associated with fertility and motherhood. And her name, I think, is pronounced Aset. But Isis is how I guess we all pronounce it now. And Isis actually means throne. Which I guess this is supposed to kind of be like a throne and the sun disk with the calf horns, I think. And so, yeah. So there's Isis, beautiful statue. And I have right here two shells, and those are for offerings. Sorry, I'm like right by my incense is killing me here. And I generally have in there rose petals or rosebuds, myrrh or garnet chips, but since we went to Mississippi, I took them out of there because I knew one of my cats would probably knock it everywhere, and I didn't want her to eat anything, get sick or anything. So, all right, so this right here is a beautiful, I don't even know what it is, I don't know if I get, it is really gorgeous. It's green, it's kind of, you can't really tell. It's all different color greens, and it's kind of swirly. I have it in the middle here because it kind of reminds me of the Nile. It's got the ebb and flow, the swirl of the coming in of the Nile, the going out of the Nile, and the fertility of the Nile. So if anybody knows what that is, please let me know because I got it at a yard sale ages ago, and they didn't know what it was. So, anyways, sorry. All right, then I have Thoth, and Thoth is my patron god. He's the god of knowledge, secrets, writing, you know, like communication. He had a different name too. It was what was it? Isdes or something? ISDES, I think. He was known that from the time of the New Kingdom on. So he had a different name, but I guess today we just know him as Thoth. And he also was known as the Judge of the Dead. So he's got, he wears many hats. But the cool thing is Isis and Thoth had a really interesting bond. If you read Egyptian history, they had a very, they had a lot of trust in each other. So, I didn't have a god for a long time. And it was on a whim that I actually found out who my god was. I actually tried to connect with Osiris because of it being Isis's husband, and I never could just bond with him. But I write a lot, and I'm a person who is very much about communication. So I don't know why I didn't see it before. It took me ages, but Thoth is my patron god, and I am ordering a statue of Thoth, and when it comes in, I'll show you if I change my altar at all. Because he is the god of the written word and communication, I have right here, I'm sorry, I'm trying not to get in the smoke of my incense. I'm going to have to move it, it's killing me. Oh, please. Okay. I have a plume and some parchment, and I know this is not made out of reeds, but it looks like it could be some kind of, you know, Egyptian basket, so I have that there by him. And I also have some dragon's blood ink. Now, I also have my god candle, which is pretty basic, you know, and my goddess candle, which is pretty basic. Now, on Isis' side, I have this really cool box, and I got it from a thrift store. I got probably, I would say, 80% of the stuff I have from thrift stores. And it's kind of got gold on it. It just looks kind of like it would be some Egyptian kind of thing. I just really love it. It's got a, please focus. Okay. It's got like this red velvet kind of insert inside of it. Now, this right here is my ribbon, or sash, if you will. And this is for walking through the House of Isis in the votary section of it. So this will be tied in a certain way, and this will be part of my ritual. I have my if it'll come out. I have my pendulum in here. And I also have some stones that sort of remind me, or no, they do remind me. They remind me of Isis, make me think of her. And then there's this. I have no idea what this is. A friend gave me this ages ago, and it used to smell like roses. It's like a pod. And it reminds me of fertility. And since Isis is a fertility goddess, I have this in here in her little kind of treasure box type thing. I have that there because I'm very much a symbolic type of person, and I'm sure like a lot of us are. And in Egypt, they had so many treasures and so many mysteries and things. So when I found this box, it just seemed like the perfect box to put on Isis's side as like her little treasure box kind of thing. All right, so sorry for the smoke. So then I have my lotus oil, and this is for anointing anything new to my altar. It's for anointing myself, my third eye, when I am doing meditations to connect with my god and goddess at this altar. It's also, I use it for anointing anything I'm charging at this altar, and so it's sort of a multi kind of oil, but I always keep it here. Alright, so this is my second representation of Bast. I got this in Salem, this little cute little thing. I do want a bigger one, but this is, I just love this one. It was the only one I could find there at the time. Alright, then there I have this pyramid. Now, this pyramid is marble, I believe. And I want to say, I don't think, I saw these at Harvard's Natural History Museum, but I don't think I got this there. I think I got it in Mississippi somewhere. I might have got it at the dollar store in Mississippi. But it's really cool. It's really hecka sharp, too. But it's you know, it's a pyramid. This was my first representation of Bast. And I know it's not in the traditional positioning, but I really loved it. And it's just an Avon perfume bottle, but I still have it there. This is my cord. It's, let me see. It's silver, gold, and white. This cord, what I did was I created this cord when I did my ritual to dedicate myself to Isis and Thoth on my 20-year anniversary of what I considered basically following the path. And I keep that at this altar as a constant reminder of my connection with the god and goddess and our binding together. And so that's there. Now this box I got at the thrift store as well. And I have no idea what this is made of, but inside of it I have these wonderful shaman stones. They're so full of energy, they're beautiful, and they're intense. Now the cool thing, one of the cool things about them, besides the fact that they're just really cool, you know, stones in general, and this might be just cool to me, but when you push on them, they feel like they squish, but they don't. I don't know. I think that's pretty cool. But anyways, they're beautiful. And a wonderful, wonderful friend of mine in Mississippi gave me those. And anytime I meditate at this altar, I always use those. They feel like very protective. So I like to use them when I'm feeling a little uneasy or maybe not, you know, completely myself. I use them anyways, but when I use them when I'm feeling that way, they just kind of have an extra oomph. So it's there. Now this is just a candle to, it's sort of an all-purpose candle. I got this in at the thrift store as well. It was purple when I bought it. And it's funny because I don't know if it's some kind of polymer or resin or something. It's not plastic, but I painted it white. And I have a white candle burning in there right now. I have a candle burning for one of my really good friends. She is in the Peace Corps in Africa right now. And she's sort of having a hard time adjusting. So I'm lighting a candle for her. But I do light candles all the time in this for multiple of reasons. And when I light this candle at this altar, I do it when I meditate. I do it when, like, for instance, with this, it's me sort of asking my god and goddess to send certain things, certain places, like to my friend in Africa, a lot of strength, a lot of healing, a lot of love, and to help her kind of adjust and things like that. So this has a multiple of uses. Now, over here, this is the last thing. I'm sorry, my cats are fighting in the background. I'll have to hurry up. This is my offering bowl, and it's got some jewelry charging on it. And these will be anointed with the lotus oil. And I also do different offerings on here, bread, fruit, whatever. But right now, there's just some things charging. I have my incense burner right here. I'm going to move it back now. But it was just smoking right in my face, so getting dirty everywhere. But anyways, that is my main god and goddess altar. Anything I do at this altar, if it's meditations, they are specifically to connect with my god and goddess. If they're invocations, they're invocations of my god and goddess. And this is a more specific altar, whereas my main altar or my my Sabbat, and I guess it would be more of my main altar. That's for connecting with multiple deities, multiple energies, and in multiple uses. But this is specific to Isis and Thoth and the energies of Egypt. And when I mean the energies of Egypt, I mean the mystery and the mysticism of Egypt, and the magic and the power of Egypt. So anything I do at this altar will have a connection of some sort to that particular tradition. So anyways, that is my altar for Isis and Thoth. It's not a whole lot to it, but I really hope you enjoyed the little tour. If you have any questions, please feel free to let me know what they are, and I'll be happy to answer them. And also, if y'all know what this is, I would really like to know, because I have no clue, and I've actually never taken the time to look it up, ironically. All right, everybody, have a wonderful day, and blessed be.